الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على خاتم المرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. يتجدد اللقاء معكم في اليوم الثالث من هذه الزيارة.
الشيخ حفظه الله ورعاه. He began by thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and praising him and sending the peace and salutations upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He says again, we renew our sitting with you on the third day of the camp.
هذه الزيارة التي أسأل الله عز وجل أن يجعلها خالصة الوجه الكريم.
This visit that I hope Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make sincerely for his face alone.
أخوكم زائركم ومحدثكم من الكويت سالم بن سعد الطويل.
And I, your brother that has visited you from the lands of Kuwait, is Salim al-Tawil.
Ibn Sa'd al-Tawil.
Ibn Sa'd al-Tawil, Abu Sa'd.
ونحن في يوم الأحد الحادي عشر من جماد الآخرة لعام 29,400.
And we are on Sunday 11th of Jumad al-Akhir 1429 that coincides with the 17th of June 2009.
الموافق الخامس عشر من الشهر السادس لعام 2008.
Oh, okay, yeah. So June 17th. So okay, we're in June 15th, 2009. 2008.
طيب again. ونحن في يوم الأحد.
We are on Sunday.
الحادي عشر.
11th
من جماد الآخرة.
From جماد الآخرة.
لعام 29,400.
1429 after the Hijra.
الموافق الخامس عشر.
That coincides with the 15th.
الشهر السادس.
Of June.
لعام 2000.
2008.
يتجدد اللقاء معكم في هذا المكان.
And now we renew our sitting with you in this place, and it's Camp Tata Pachu.
أذكر المكان عنوان. أمريكا.
The state of California in the country of the United States of America.
يقول الله عز وجل لنبيه صلى الله عليه وسلم نحن نقص عليك أحسن القصص.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says to the Prophet, we are going to give you the best stories.
وقد اعتاد كثير من الناس.
And many of the people became accustomed to.
أن يقص على الناس قصصا.
To tell stories to the people.
ويكثر من القصص
and they have many of these stories
ويترك الكتاب والسنة
yet they leave the book and the sunnah
وهذا يسمون القصاصون
and they call these people the storytellers
فإنهم عجزوا عن حفظ نصوص الكتاب والسنة
where they were not able to memorize the text of the book and the sunnah
فاشتغلوا بالقصص المروية هنا وهناك
So what they did was work themselves with the stories that have been narrated here and there.
وكثير منها فيها كذب.
And many of it, there is lies in it.
وتزوير وزيادة ونقصان.
And there is additions and subtractions from it.
والناس تهوى وتحب القصص.
And the people they like and want to hear the stories.
فإن كان لابد.
And if there is no way but to tell a story.
فعلينا بقصص القرآن والسنة.
And we should tell the stories that came in the Quran and the Sunnah.
فإنها وحي من الله عز وجل.
Because it is a revelation from Allah عز وجل.
يقول الله لقد كان لكم في قصصهم عبرة.
Allah سبحانه وتعالى says for you there were for you in their stories there was a lesson for you in their stories.
فأحسن القصص قصص القرآن والسنة.
So the best stories are the ones that come in the Quran and the Sunnah.
والعبر في الكتاب والسنة.
And the lessons come from the Kitab and the Sunnah.
لذلك نريد أن نستغل هذا الوقت في هذا الصباح الباكر.
So we would like to then take this opportunity in this morning to take advantage of this time.
ونرطب أسماعكم.
And that we may bring upon your hearing.
قصة ذكرت في الكتاب والسنة.
A story that was recorded in the book and the Sunnah.
ألا وهي قصة أصحاب الأخدود.
And it is the story of أصحاب الأخدود.
والأخدود معناها الحفر التي تحفر في الأرض.
And the أخدود companion means ditches or holes in the ground.
وهذه القصة التي ذكر الله في سورة البروج.
And it is a story that Allah سبحانه وتعالى spoke about in سورة البروج.
وهي أمة من الأمم.
It is one of the nations that passed before.
ابتليت بطاغية كبير.
That was tested with a great tyrant.
كان يدعوهم إلى عبادة نفسه من دون الله عز وجل.
And he used to call the people to worship him other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
وعذبهم عذابا شديدا.
And he punished them great punishments.
وثبتوا على دينهم.
And they still stayed firm upon their deen.
حتى يقتدي ذكر الله لنا ذلك حتى يقتدي بهم من أراد أن يقتدي.
And he recalled this to us, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so that whoever wants to have a role model, there should be a role model for him.
يقول الله تبارك وتعالى.
Allah تبارك وتعالى says.
قتل أصحاب الأخدود النار ذات الوقود إذ هم عليها قعود وهم على ما يفعلون بالمؤمنين شهود وما نقوا منهم إلا أن يؤمنوا بالله العزيز الحميد الذي له ملك السماوات والأرض والله على كل شيء شهيد إن الذين فتنوا المؤمنين والمؤمنات ثم لم يتوبوا فلهم عذاب جهنم ولهم عذاب الحريق إن الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات لهم جنات تجري من تحت أنهار ذلك الفوز الكبير هذا ما سنفسره في هذه الجلسة.
Inshallah, the brother, he's going to go get me a translated Quran so I can read to you from that. But the Sheikh, he noted some of the ayat concerning the companions of the ditch, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about them and their fitna. And he's going to go ahead and make the tafsir of these ayat. I'm going to wait to even try to translate those till he brings the book, inshallah.
وقد فسر النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم هذه القصة.
And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, he gave us the explanation of this story.
كما في حديث صهيب رضي الله عنه الذي رواه مسلم في صحيحه.
As is in the hadith of Suhayb رضي الله عنه, and it's recorded in Sahih Muslim.
يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كان في من كان قبلكم.
The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, there was from the people from before you.
كان ملك وكان عنده ساحر.
There was a king and he had a magician.
وهذا الملك قد اتخذ هذا الساحر ليسحر له.
And this king he took this magician so that he may cast magic over the people for him.
فالساحر هذا من حاشية الملك.
So the magician he is from the people that are close to the king.
يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فلما كبر الساحر قال للملك ابعث إني قد كبرت فابعث إلي غلاما أعلمه السحر.
So when the magician he became old, he told the king, "I'm getting old, so why don't you find some young man that I may teach him?"
أراد الساحر من الملك أن يرسل له غلاما أي شابا صغيرا يعلمه السحر لأن الصغار أدعى للتعليم.
He asked that he bring him a young man so he could teach him his magic and sorcery. And he chose somebody young because they're easier to teach.
وهكذا ينبغي أن نعتني بالصغار فإن الصغار يحفظون سريعا.
And this is something we should take note of so that we may also try to teach our young because they are able to record the knowledge easier.
حتى أن أحدنا يتذكر أنه حفظ أشياء في صغره يعجز أن يحفظ الآن لما كبر.
Even to the point that some of us we might notice that we have memorized things in our youth that if we tried today we wouldn't be able to.
حتى كما قيل الحفظ في الصغر كالنقش على الحجر.
And as it said, memorization in the young age is like chiseling into the stone.
فاختار الملك غلاما فبعثه إلى الساحر ليعلمه السحر.
So the king he chose a young man to send him to the magician.
وكان هذا الغلام ينتقل من أهله إلى الساحر ومن الساحر إلى أهله.
So the young man, what he would do is he would travel between his family to the sorcerer or magician and back and forth in this manner.
وكان إذا تأخر على الساحر ضربه الساحر.
And if he used to be late, then the magician he would hit him.
وكان بين أهل الغلام وبين الساحر راهب والراهب هو العابد من بني إسرائيل.
There used to be between the place of where his family was and where the magician or sorcerer that he had to meet, there was a rahib, and the rahib is somebody that used to be a person of worship from Bani Israel.
فكان الغلام يجلس عند الراهب فيسمع كلامه فأعجبه كلامه.
So the young man he would sit with this person that used to worship Allah, and he'd listen to his words and he'd like him.
فكان الغلام يسمع من كلام الإيمان من الراهب ويسمع من السحر من الساحر.
So he would listen, the young man, he would listen to the man that would worship Allah, and then he would listen to the sorcerer.
وكان الراهب يعامله معاملة حسنة بينما الساحر كان يضربه.
And the راهب, the person that worships Allah here from Bani Israel, he used to deal with him in a good manner, but the sorcerer, he would hit him.
فاشتكى الغلام إلى الراهب أن الساحر يضربه.
So the young man, he complained. He complained to the راهب that this magician, he keeps hitting him.
فقال الراهب الغلام إذا جئت الساحر فقل حبسني أهلي وإذا جئت أهلي أهلك فقل حبسني الساحر.
So the راهب, he told the young man, he said, well, if you go to the sorcerer, tell him that my family kept me behind. And if you go to your family, because he was late, and if you go to your family, then tell them that the sorcerer kept me behind.
فبينما كان الغلام بين الراهب والساحر,
so while the young man was between the going back and forth between the راهب, the راهب and the magician,
اختار الغلام أي الاثنين أحب وأفضل عند الله عز وجل, الراهب أم الساحر.
So the young man, he wanted to see which is better with Allah Azza wa Jal, the sorcerer or the man that worshipped Allah.
فاحتاج أن يلجأ إلى الله عز وجل ليبصره ويخبره أي الأمرين أحب إلى الله عز وجل, الساحر أم الراهب.
So he wanted to see, he wanted to go back, he had to go back to Allah and return to him to seek guidance, which is better, the sorcery or what the worshipping man is teaching me.
ومن توجه إلى الله عز وجل بصدق فإن الله عز وجل يهديه.
And whoever turns to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala truthfully and sincerely, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will guide him.
فمر الغلام ذات يوم بدابة كبيرة, حيوان عظيم قد حبس طريق الناس أو قد قطع طريق الناس عليهم.
And the young man, one day he was passing by a path and there was a great beast and it had stopped, you know, had cut off the route off from the people, so
فقال اليوم أعلم أمر الراهب أحب إلى الله أم أمر الساحر.
Today I will know which is better, the affair of Allah with Allah, the affair of the راهب or the affair of the sorcerer.
فأخذ حجرا وقال,
so he took a rock and said,
اللهم إن كان أمر الراهب أحب إليك من أمر الساحر فاقتل هذه الدابة حتى يمضي الناس.
Say, oh Allah, if the affair of the راهب, the one that worshipped the worshipper, is more beloved to you than the affair of the sorcerer,
والذي يظهر,
then kill this animal.
والذي يظهر أن هذا الغلام كان صادقا في لجوئه إلى الله تبارك وتعالى.
And what is apparent is that this young man, he was truthful and sincere in seeking from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the guidance.
فرمى تلك الدابة فقتلها ومضى الناس.
So he threw the rock and it did kill the beast and the people were able to pass.
فظهر له أن أمر الراهب عند الله أحب من أمر الساحر.
So it became clear to him that the affair of the راهب, the worshipping man, is more beloved to Allah than the affair of the sorcerer.
فرجع إلى الراهب وأخبره بالخبر.
So he returned back to the راهب and he told him about what happened.
فقال الراهب أي بني إنك أنت اليوم أفضل مني.
And the راهب, he said to him, oh my son, today you are better than me.
وهذا فضل الله يؤتيه من يشاء.
And this is the favor of Allah, he gives it to who he wishes.
مع أن الراهب كان أسبق في عبادته لله من الغلام.
Even though we find that the راهب, the worshipping man, he preceded the young man in worship and knowing Allah.
لكن الغلام تفوق على الراهب وآتاه الله ورزقه من فضله.
But the young man, he was favored over the راهب and Allah سبحانه وتعالى gave him from the favors.
فقال له إنك اليوم خير أفضل مني.
He said, today you are better than me.
وإنك ستبتلى سيختبرك الله عز وجل وهذا لا بد منه.
And he said, you will be tested and examined, and this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will do, and there's no way around it.
وكما تعلمون أن البلاء سنة الله في خلقه لا بد أن يبتلي ويختبر.
And as you know, that the test is the way of Allah with his creation. Everybody has to go through it.
والله عز وجل يقول الذي خلق الموت والحياة ليبلوكم أيكم أحسن عملا.
So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, the one that created the life and death, so he may test you, which of you is best in actions.
ويقول ألف لام ميم أحسب الناس أيظن الناس أن يتركوا أن يقولوا آمنا وهم لا يفتنون بدون اختبار هكذا يظن الناس.
And he said ألف لام ميم, is it that the people think that they will say that they have believed and they will not be tested.
ولقد فتنا الذين من قبلهم أي الأمم السابقة أيضا اختبرهم الله عز وجل.
And we have tested those from before them.
ومن هؤلاء الأمم السابقة التي اختبر الله عز وجل هذه الأمة أصحاب الأخدود.
And from the nations that Allah Azza wa Jal had tested were this nation, the companions of the ditch.
فالراهب يقول للغلام إنك ستبتلى.
So the راهب, the worshiping man, he tells the young man, he says, you'll be tested.
قال فلا تدلهم علي.
He told them, so don't let them know where I am, where I reside.
فأخذ بالأسباب واحتاط لنفسه وهذا لا بأس به.
So he took by the means to protect himself, and this is no, there's no problem with this.
إن استطعت ألا تدلهم علي فلا تدلهم علي.
So if you are able to keep them from knowing where I am and not letting them know where I am, don't let them know.
وكان هذا الغلام قد آتاه الله عز وجل من فضله.
And this young man, Allah عز وجل had given him favors.
كان يبرئ الأكمة. الأكمة هو الذي الإنسان الذي ولد أعمى.
And from the favors Allah سبحانه وتعالى gave is that he was able to cure the blind.
ويبرئ الأبرص. الأبرص البرص هو اللون المتغير في الجلد.
And he would cure the leprosy of the, if somebody had it.
ويداوي الناس من سائر الأدواء.
And he had other things that he would cure the people from.
وهذا فضل الله يؤتيه من يشاء.
And again, this is the favors of Allah. He gives it to who he wishes.
فسمع بالغلام رجل أعمى.
So a blind man heard about this young man.
جليس للملك.
And he is somebody that is close to them. He sits with the king.
فأتى بهدايا كثيرة.
And he came with many gifts to the young man.
إلى الغلام وقال له.
And he said to him,
ما ها هنا من الهدايا أجمع لك إن أنت شفيتني.
He said, all of these gifts I bring to you are for you if you cure me.
فقال الغلام إني لا أشفي أحدا.
So the young man, he said, I don't give cure to anyone.
إنما يشفي الله عز وجل.
Rather, it is Allah عز وجل that cures.
فإن أنت آمنت بالله.
So if you believe in Allah.
دعوت الله فيشفيك الله.
الله سبحانه هو دعا الله ولا من؟ أنا دعوت الله ولا أنت تدعو الله؟
الغلام يدعو الله يشفيك.
I will make dua to Allah for you so that He may cure you.
فآمن جليس الملك الأعمى.
So this blind man that actually sits with the king, he believed in what the young man said.
فدعا الغلام ربه فرد الله عز وجل الأعمى بصره.
So he made dua to Allah, and Allah سبحانه وتعالى actually did return the eyesight to the sight to this man.
فرجع الأعمى وجلس عند الملك.
So the blind man, he went back and sat with the king.
فلما رأى الملك قال ما رد عليك بصرك.
When the king saw him, he said, what returned back to you your sight?
قال الله.
He responded, Allah.
قال الملك ألك رب غيري.
The king said, do you have any other lord beside me?
قال ربي وربك الله.
He said, the blind man responded back, he said, rather, my lord and your lord is Allah.
فأخذه فما زال يعذبه.
So he took him and continued to punish him.
حتى دل على الغلام.
Until he informed them it was the young man that.
فأتي بالغلام إلى الملك.
So the young man was brought forth to the king.
فقال أي بني قد بلغ من سحرك أنك تبرئ الأكمه أو تبرئ الأبرص وتشفي الناس من سائر الأدواء وترد للناس أبصارهم.
He said, so the king said to the boy, he said,
تبرئ الأكمه والأبرص وتداوي الناس من سائر الأدواء.
He said to him, your magic has reached the point that you can cure the blind or the one that had leprosy or any other illness.
ظن الملك أن هذا الغلام قد تعلم السحر إلى درجة أنه يعالج الناس ويبرئ الأكمه والأبرص.
So the king thought that his magic reached to the point that he can cure these ills.
فقال الغلام إني لا أشفي أحدا إنما يشفي الله عز وجل.
So the young man said, I don't cure anyone, rather it is Allah that cures the people.
فقال الملك أولك رب غيري.
The king said, and do you have a lord beside me?
قال ربي وربك الله.
He responded back, rather my lord and your lord is Allah.
فأخذه فما زال يعذبه حتى دل على الراهب.
So he took him and continued to punish him until he informed about the راهب, the man that used to worship.
وهذا من البلاء العظيم أن يؤذى الإنسان في سبيل دينه.
And this is from the great test that the person be punished due to his deen.
فأتي بالراهب إلى الملك.
So this worshipping راهب, he was brought forth to the king.
فقال له ارجع عن دينك.
And they told him, return back from your religion.
فماذا تتوقعون؟
So what do you think he did?
أبى أن يرجع عن دينه.
He refused.
فأمر الملك بمنشار.
So the king, he brought forth a saw.
فوضع على مفرق رأسه فشقه نصفين ولم يرجع عن دينه.
And it was put down in the middle of his head, and it was, and then he was cut in two halves, and he did not go back from his religion.
ثم أتى بجليسه الذي كان أعمى.
Then he brought the blind. He brought the guy that used to sit with him that was blind.
فقال له ارجع عن دينك.
And he told him, "You too, return back from your deen."
فأبى أن يرجع عن دينه.
And he too refused.
فأمر بمنشار فوضع على مفرق رأسه فشقه نصفين ولم يرجع عن دينه.
And again, he brought the saw and cut him in two halves, and the man, he did not return back from his deen.
انظر إلى إيمان هؤلاء.
Look at the belief of these two.
كم كلفهم التمسك بالدين وما ردوا عن دينهم.
What they're holding fast to the deen costed them, and they still did not return back from it.
ربما بعضنا ينفتن اليوم.
Maybe some of us they're tested today.
بأدنى المغريات.
And they have fitna with the least of the things that will make you want to lose your religion.
أو لو سمع خبر بأن الذي يستقيم على دينه سيؤذى.
Or that he heard something, the one that you know he's sticking to his deen, he hears something that he will be harmed in some way.
أو سيطرد من عمله.
Or that he'll be kicked from his job.
أو سيفعل به كذا وكذا.
Or that so such and such might happen to him.
ربما لو سمع طرفا من الخبر لاهتز إيمانه.
Even if he hears part of this information, his iman is shaken.
وذلك لضعف الإيمان.
This is due to his weakness in iman.
وقلة اليقين.
And not having enough certainty.
وقلة الرغبة فيما عند الله عز وجل.
And not really wanting what is with Allah عز وجل.
فما عند الله خير وأبقى من هذه الدنيا كلها.
What is with Allah is better and for everlasting, better than what is in this dunya.
فهؤلاء شق كل منهم نصفين ولم يرجع عن دينه.
So look, these two people, they were split in two halves, and yet they did not return back from their deen.
ثم أتى بالغلام فقال له أي بني ارجع عن دينك.
Then he brought forth the young man.
فأبى أن يرجع عن دينه.
And told him, come back, return back from your religion, and he refused.
فدفعه إلى نفر من أصحابه.
So he put him forth to some of his people.
This lecture has been distributed by SalafiTapes.com.
قال خذوه واصعدوا به جبل كذا وكذا.
He told them, take him and go up the mountain with him.
حتى إذا بلغتم ذروة الجبل.
Until you reach the top of the mountain.
فإن رجع عن دينه وإلا فاقذفوه.
Either he returns back from his religion up there or you throw him off.
فأخذوه وصعدوا به الجبل.
They took him and went up the mountain.
حتى إذا بلغوا ذروة الجبل.
Until they reach the top of it.
قاله ارجع عن دينك.
Yeah, return back from your deen now.
فأبى أن يرجع عن دينه.
And he refused.
فلما أرادوا أن يرموه من أعلى الجبل.
And when they wanted to throw him off the top of the mountain.
توجه إلى الله بالدعاء.
He went toward Allah سبحانه وتعالى making دعاء.
وقال اللهم اكفينهم بما شئت. اللهم اكفينهم بما شئت. فكفاه الله شرهم.
He said, oh Allah, finish me from them how you wish. Finish me from them how you wish. And Allah سبحانه وتعالى, he took care of them.
يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فارتجف بهم الجبل وتساقطوا ورجع يمشي إلى الملك.
So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said the mountain shook with them. They all fell off and he returned back walking to the king.
فلما رآه الملك قال أي بني ما فعل أصحابك.
The king, when he saw him, he says, oh my son, what happened to those that I sent with you?
قال كفانيهم الله عز وجل.
He said, Allah took care of them for me.
ثم دفع إلى نفر من أصحابه.
Then he sent more of his companions with the boy.
فقال اذهبوا واحملوه في قرقور أي سفينة صغيرة.
And he told them, all right, you go and you put him in a little ship.
ثم توسطوا فيه البحر.
And get into the middle of the ocean.
فإن رجع عن دينه وإلا فرموه في البحر.
And he either returns back from his deen or you throw him in the ocean.
فحملوه في قرقور وتوسطوا به البحر.
So they carried him in the ship and got to the middle of the ocean.
ثم قالوا ارجع عن دينك.
And they told him, return back from your deen.
فأبى أن يرجع عن دينه.
And he refused again.
فلما أرادوا أن يقذفوه في البحر.
And when they wanted to throw him into the ocean.
توجه إلى الله بالدعاء.
He turned to Allah in supplication.
قال اللهم اكفينيهم بما شئت.
Say, oh Allah, take care of them as you wish.
اللهم اكفينيهم بما شئت.
So Allah, finish me from their evil as you wish.
قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said.
فانكفأت بهم السفينة. أي انقلبت بهم السفينة.
So he said that the little boat, it flipped over on them, it capsized.
وغرقوا.
And they all drowned.
ورجع الغلام يمشي إلى الملك.
And the young man, he returned back walking to the king.
قال أي بني ما فعل أصحابك.
He said, oh my son, the king says to him, oh my son, what happened to your friends there?
قال كفانيهم الله عز وجل.
He said, Allah سبحانه وتعالى, he took care of them for me.
ثم قال الملك ثم قال الغلام للملك
And then the young man said to the king
إنك لست قاتلا
He said you can't kill me
حتى تفعل ما أمرك به
Until you do what I order you with
قال وما ذاك
He said what is that
قال تجمع الناس في صعيد واحد في أرض واحدة
He said you bring the people into one piece of land
ثم تصلبني على جذع نخلة
And then you tie me up to a tree
ثم تأخذ سهما من كنانتي
And then you take an arrow from mine
ثم تضع السهم في كبد القوس
And then you put it into the bow
ثم تقول بسم الله رب الغلام
And then you say بسم الله In the name of Allah the Lord of this young man
بسم الله رب الغلام
بسم الله the Lord of this غلام
فإذا فعلت ذلك قتلتني
If you're able to do this then you'll be able to kill me
فقام الملك وجمع الناس في صعيد واحد.
So the Malik, the king, he went ahead and did so. He brought the people.
وصلب الغلام على جذع نخلة.
And he tied the boy to the tree.
وأخذ سهما من كنانته.
And he took one of his arrows.
ووضع السهم في كبد القوس.
And then he put it into the bow.
وقال بسم الله رب الغلام.
And then he said بسم الله the Lord of the غلام.
والناس يسمعون ذلك.
And the people all heard this.
فرماه.
And he shot him.
فوقع السهم في صدغه ما بين أذنه وعينه. وقع السهم في صدغ الغلام.
And the arrow actually went right through where between the eye and the ear.
فوضع يده على صدغه.
So he put his hand onto it.
فمات الغلام.
And the young man he died.
فقال الناس.
So the people started to say.
آمنا برب الغلام. آمنا برب الغلام.
We believe in the Lord of this young boy. We believe in the Lord of this young boy.
فأتى أناس إلى الملك.
So people came to the king.
فقال ورأيت ما كنت تحذر الشيء الذي كنت تحذر منه.
Do you see that which you used to fear?
قال وما ذاك؟
And he said, what is it? They told him that.
فأقسموا له بالله. قالوا والله قد وقع بك حذرك. قد آمن الناس جميعا.
They said to him, by Allah, that which you feared has befallen you. The people have believed in Allah other than you.
فأمر بالأخاديد فقدت الحفر فحفرت.
So they were. Then he ordered that the ditches be dug up.
وأمر بالنيران فأضرمت أشعلت النيران في الحفر.
And he ordered that the fire be lit in these ditches.
وقال لجنوده من لم يرجع عن دينه فاقذفوه في النار.
He said to his soldiers, whoever does not return back from his deen, throw him into the fire.
وكانت تلك الأمة.
And this nation.
ليس لهم اختيار.
They had no option.
إلا أن يكفروا. أو يموتوا في سبيل الله.
Except that they either disbelieve or that they die.
نعم هذه الأمة قد رحمها الله عز وجل.
They die believing in Allah. But this ummah Allah has had mercy on it.
فيجوز الإنسان إذا اضطر أن يتكلم بكلمة الكفر ظاهرا.
If it is permissible for the person, if it is necessary for him, that he might say the word of kufr apparently.
أن يتكلم بها.
You know, just to say it, to get himself rid of the punishment.
بشرط أن يكون قلبه مطمئن بالإيمان.
As long, well, the condition to this is that his heart is filled with iman.
يقول الله عز وجل إلا من أكره وقلبه مطمئن بالإيمان.
As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, which means except for the one that is forced to unwillingly, and his heart is filled and content with iman.
لكن الأمم السابقة.
But the nations before.
ما كان عندهم هذا الحكم.
They didn't have the same ruling.
أي حكم؟
What did they have?
الإكراه.
The ruling of إكراه, meaning if you are forced unwillingly to do something.
فإذا اضطر أحدهم إلى أن يقول الكفر.
So if one of them was forced to say a word of كفر.
فلا بد أن يثبت ولو قتل.
Then it's binding upon them to stay firm even to the death.
وهكذا هذه الأمة أصحاب الأخدود.
And likewise, this ummah, the companions of the ditch.
أشعل لهم النيران في الحفر.
The fire was lit for them in the ditches.
وقال من لم يرجع عن دينه فاقذفوه في النار.
And they said, whoever does not return back from his deen from these people, throw him into the fire.
فأخذوا يقذفونهم في النار ولا يرجعون عن دينه.
So they took throwing them into the fire, and the people still did not return back from their deen.
يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said.
حتى جاءت امرأة ومعها صبي لها.
Until a woman came and she had a boy of hers.
وهذا الصبي صغير لا يتكلم.
And this is a little boy, he doesn't speak.
فتقاعست أن تقع في النار، ترددت خوفا على نفسها وصغيرها أن تلقى في النار من أجل دينها.
So when she came upon the fire, she had a little bit of hesitation because she had a little boy.
فقال الصبي أنطقه الله عز وجل، فقال الصبي يا أمة اصبري.
So the little boy, he said to his mother, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made him speak, "Oh my mother, have patience."
فقذفت نفسها وابنها في النار.
So she went ahead and went into the fire with her son.
هذا ما قصه لنا النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
This is what the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم informed us of.
عن أصحاب الأخدود.
Of the companions of the ditch.
التي ذكر الله في كتابه.
Those that Allah سبحانه وتعالى recorded in His book.
يقول الله عز وجل.
Allah عز وجل says,
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والسماء ذات البروج واليوم الموعود وشاهد ومشهود قتل أصحاب الأخدود النار ذات الوقود إذ هم عليها قعود وهم على ما يفعلون بالمؤمنين شهود وما نقموا منهم إلا أن يؤمنوا بالله العزيز الحميد الذي له ملك السماوات والأرض والله على كل شيء شهيد إن الذين فتنوا المؤمنين والمؤمنات ثم لم يتوبوا فلهم عذاب جهنم ولهم عذاب الحريق إن الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات لهم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار ذلك الفوز الكبير إن بطش ربك لشديد إنه هو يبدئ ويعيد وهو الغفور الودود فعال لما يريد هل أتاك حديث الجنود فرعون وثمود بل الذين كفروا في تكذيب والله من ورائهم محيط بل هو قرآن مجيد في لوح محفوظ هذه القصة ذكر الله عز وجل في هذه السورة.
This is the story of أصحاب الأخدود in سورة البروج. I think we all picked up.
والله يقول فيها
Allah سبحانه وتعالى says in it
إن الذين فتنوا المؤمنين والمؤمنات أي الذين اختبروا المؤمنين والمؤمنات في دينهم
Those that tested the believing men and women in their deen.
يقول الله عز وجل قتل أصحاب الأخدود يعني قتل يعني لعن أصحاب الأخدود أولئك الذين عذبوا الناس بالأخدود الذين قاموا في النار.
Killed or meaning cursed be the companions those people that dug the ditch.
قتل أصحاب الأخدود أي لعن أصحاب الأخدود الذين فعلوا ذلك بالناس.
That means may the ones that dug the ditches be killed, cursed for what they did to the people.
النار ذات الوقود, النار التي فيها وقود يحرقون بها الناس.
The fire.
إذ هم عليها قعود, يعني كانوا شاهدين وهم يرون الناس يعذبون. ما فعل هذا من ورائهم وهم لا يعلمون. هذا بأمر منهم وهم يشاهدون هذا الشيء.
If these fires are lit while they are there to testify and see that it's happening. Meaning they're present, not doing anything. It didn't happen while they did not have knowledge.
وهم على ما يفعلون بالمؤمن الشهود. كان هذا العذاب أمامهم شاهد يشهدونه يحرقون الناس بالنار.
And this is something they witnessed and saw how the fire was killing these people.
بأي ذنب قتلوهم.
By whose command did they kill these innocent people?
بلا ذنب.
For no reason, they had nothing. They were innocent of everything.
ما في ذنب قد اقترفوه حتى يعذبوا هذا العذاب.
There is no sin or no harm that they did that they deserve such a punishment.
إنما فعلوا من ذلك شيء واحد.
Rather, they only punished them for one reason.
لأنهم آمنوا بالله العزيز الحميد.
Because they believed in Allah.
وهذا أعظم جرم.
This is the worst of crimes.
يفتنون الناس بالنار ويحرقون بالنار لأنهم آمنوا بالله عز وجل.
They're going to test the people and try to make them return back from the religion with the fire because they believed in Allah.
والله يستحق العبادة والإيمان.
And Allah سبحانه وتعالى what's befitting of Him is that you believe in Him and have faith.
فهو له ملك السماوات والأرض.
Because he has the he controls or owns the heavens and earth.
والله كان شهيد على ما يفعلون لا تخفى عليه خافية.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala he was a witness of what they did. Nothing is hidden from him.
هل بعد هذه الجريمة جريمة؟
Is there any crime after such a crime?
إنها من أبشع الجرائم في التاريخ.
It's from one of the worst crimes in history.
يحرق الناس بالنار.
He kills the people with fire.
لا لأي سبب.
For no reason except.
إلا لأنهم آمنوا بالله العزيز الحميد.
They believed in Allah.
وكان هذا الطاغي يقول للناس.
And this tyrant he would say to the people.
أنا ربكم الأعلى.
I am your Lord that is most high.
ليس لكم رب سواي.
You have no Lord beside me.
فجمع بين كثير من الذنوب.
So he combined many of the sins.
وكافر بالله.
He disbelieved in Allah.
يدعي نفسه الربوبية.
He claims for himself lordship.
يفتن المؤمنين بالنار.
He tests the people with the hellfire, the believers.
يحرق بالنار من لا يكفر بالله عز وجل.
Then he burns in the fire the one that does not believe in Allah عز وجل.
هذه الجرائم المتعددة الكثيرة المتراكمة بعضها على بعض.
And these crimes that are numerous and one upon the next.
ماذا يقول الله عز وجل عنهم؟
What does Allah say about them?
يقول إن الذين فتنوا المؤمنين والمؤمنات ثم لم يتوبوا. تأملوا كلمة ثم لم يتوبوا.
He says those that believe the believing women who test the believing women and men and then they do not return back in repentance to Allah.
مع أنهم فعلوا هذه الجرائم كلها.
Even though they did all of these crimes.
وما تابوا.
They did not repent.
فقوله جل وعلا ثم لم يتوبوا.
So his statement, Azza wa Jal, they did not, and then they did not repent back to Allah.
قال بعض العلماء.
Some of the ulama state.
قوله تعالى ثم لم يتوبوا.
The statement that of Allah subhanahu wa taala, and then they did not repent.
أي أنهم لو تابوا لتاب الله عليهم.
That if they did repent, Allah subhanahu wa taala would have accepted it.
انظر إلى سعة رحمة الله عز وجل.
Look how great the mercy of Allah Azza wa Jal is.
فعلوا هذه الذنوب كلها.
They did all of these crimes.
أنكر الله عز وجل.
They refused Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's lordship.
وكفر بالله.
And they disbelieved in Allah.
وقال للناس أنا ربكم.
And he said I am your Lord.
وفتن الناس بالنار.
And then he tested the believers with the fire.
وأحرقهم بالنار.
And he actually did burn them and kill them.
ولو تاب بعد ما فعل هذا كله لتاب الله عليه.
And if he repented after all of this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would have يعني accepted.
لكنه ما تاب إلى الله عز وجل.
But he did not.
فعاقبهم الله عز وجل كما فعل.
So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala he punished them.
قال ثم لم يتوبوا فلهم عذاب جهنم ولهم عذاب الحريق سيحرقهم الله بالنار كما أحرق عباد الله.
He said so their punishment is that they have the fire of Jahannam and for them is that they will be burned so like they burned those people.
وأين مصير أولئك الذين احترقوا بالنار.
And where is the abode of those that were put into that fire.
قال جل وعلا إن الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات.
Allah Jalla wa Ala, he says, those that believed and did righteous actions.
لهم جنات تجري من تحت أنهار.
They have a paradise or they have gardens in which rivers flow.
ذلك الفوز الكبير.
And that is the greatest victory.
الفوز الكبير أن يفوز الإنسان بالآخرة في جنات النعيم.
The greatest victory is to have the victory of the last day to attain paradise.
كما قال الله عز وجل.
As Allah Azza wa Jal states.
فمن زحزح عن النار وادخل الجنة فقد فاز.
The one that is he is taken away from the hellfire and entered into Jannah, then he has attained victory.
Allah يقول إن بطش ربك لشديد بطش وعذابه شديد.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala he says his punishment your Lord's punishment is severe.
إنه يبدأ ويعيد يبدأ الأشياء ويعيدها.
He begins things, he creates them in the beginning and he will return them back.
الله عز فعال لما يريد يفعل ما شاء.
Allah does as he wills, he does as he wishes.
هذه القصة العظيمة
this great story
فيها فوائد كثيرة
has many benefits.
فمن يذكر لنا فائدة استفادها منها.
Can somebody tell us of a benefit that they benefited from this story?
هل استفدت منها شيئا؟
Has anybody benefited something from it?
من يذكر لنا فائدة استفادها؟
Can somebody please tell us of a benefit that they benefited from this story? الصبر على الصبر.
نعم الصبر
يعني في المصائب.
نعم عند المصائب في سبيل المحافظة على الدين. طيب.
Patience upon trials when you know in order to preserve your deen.
أيضا فائدة أخرى. نعم. أتفتح لنا باب كذا مصلحة ما؟
الله هسه.
المصلحة الناس. طيب. يقول أنه كذب على أو ورّى تعمل التورية يعني مع الساحر. قال إذا تأخر قال حبسني أهلي، وإذا تأخر عند عن أهله قال حبسني الساحر. وهذا لا بأس به، يستعمل مع الأعداء.
So another benefit that we might have is that we might make up something in order to attain a benefit, such as what the young man did. He told the sorcerer that his family kept him back, and he told his family the sorcerer kept him back, you know, in order to benefit.
في فائدة كبيرة، هي أوضح فائدة في هذا في هذه القصة، وهي لا في فائدة كبيرة جدا، يعني أوضح فائدة في هذه القصة. الله فائدة، هي كلها قصة برا. في فائدة كبيرة في واضح في هذا الحديث.
التوكيل على الله وحده.
الابتلاء.
The tests.
لا بد من الاختبار.
But Allah will test you. This is the greatest benefit that you will take from this story.
وهذه القصة فيها ابتلاء عظيم.
And this story has a great.
في سبيل الدين.
In order to preserve the deen.
فهيئ نفسك يا مسلم.
So prepare yourself, O Muslim.
أنك ستبتلى.
That you will be tested.
لكن متى موعد الابتلاء؟
But when is the time of testing?
وما هو مقرر الابتلاء الذي ستختبر به؟
And what will you be tested with?
أليس إذا كنت دارسا في طالبا في في المدرسة أو في الجامعة في موعد الاختبار؟
Is it not that, that when you study as a student that you will be tested?
في منهج محدد ستختبر به.
And there's certain topics and issues you will be tested on and examined.
أما ابتلاء في إيمانك؟
As for your إيمان.
فتوقعه في أي لحظة.
Then at any time it may come. The test may come at any point in time.
غير محدد.
There is no restrictions and boundaries.
قد تبتلى بزوجتك.
You might be tested with your زوج.
تبتلى بأولادك.
Maybe your children.
تبتلى بمالك.
Maybe your wealth.
تبتلى بصحتك.
Maybe your health.
تبتلى بسمعتك.
Maybe your يعني the people's remembrance of you.
تبتلى بوظيفتك.
Maybe your job.
البلاء كثير.
The tests are many.
يقول الله عز وجل ونبلوهم.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and we will test them.
بالشر والخير فتنة وإلينا يرجعون.
With good and we will test them with the good and the bad, and to us they will return.
ويقول الله عز وجل ولا نبلونكم.
And Allah عز وجل, He says, and we will test you.
بشيء من الخوف.
With some fear.
والجوع.
And hunger.
ونقص من الأموال والأنفس.
And يعني decreasing of wealth and the people.
والثمرات.
And fruits.
وبشر الصابرين.
And give glad tidings to those who are patient.
الذين إذا أصابتهم مصيبة.
Those that if they are tested with a trial.
قالوا إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون.
That say from Allah we came into Him and we return.
إنا لله الله يملكنا يفعل بنا ما يشاء.
We are to Allah. We are for Allah. He is our King and He does with us as He wills.
وإنا إليه راجعون. المصير إلى الله. الرجوع إلى الله.
And surely to Him we will return.
فكلنا سيرجع إلى الله عز وجل.
So in the end, we will all return to Him.
كل نفس ذائقة الموت.
Every soul will taste death.
لن يبقى أحد.
There will be no one left.
مهما طالت سلامتك.
No matter how long you live and you're healthy.
وحافظت على صحتك.
And you stay healthy.
وأخذت بالأسباب.
And you take the means to do this.
لا بد أن تموت وتفنى دنياك.
In the end, you still will die and your dunya will go away.
لقد مات رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم died.
وهو أحب الخلق إلى الله عز وجل.
He is the most beloved creation to Allah عز وجل.
فليس خسران أن تموت.
So it's no loss if you die.
لكن العبرة ماذا سيكون مصيرك بعد الموت.
But the lesson is what is after death for you.
فأهم ما في هذه القصة.
So what is it, the most important thing in this story.
الابتلاء والاختبار.
The testing and trials you
في سبيل دينك.
In order to preserve your deen.
لا بد أن تختبر وتبتلى.
You will be tested and examined.
ولا بد لك من الصبر.
And you must be patient.
ولا بد لك من الدعاء واللجوء إلى الله عز وجل.
And you must supplicate and turn to Allah عز وجل.
ولا تستهين بنفسك تقول أنا سام شخص واحد ماذا سأفعل.
And do not put down yourself and say I am one person, what can I do.
هذا غلام.
This is a young man.
يعني شاب صغير.
يعني young man.
استطاع أن يضحي بنفسه.
He was able to sacrifice himself.
وأرشد الملك كيف يقتله.
He taught the king how to kill him.
من أجل أن ينقذ أمة كاملة.
In order that he may save a whole nation.
دخلوا الإسلام.
And that entered into Islam.
وأمنوا آخرتهم.
And what they did was secure their last, their last, يعني the life after.
ونجوا من الكفر ومن النيران.
And they saved themselves from kufr and from fire.
This lecture has been distributed by SalafiTapes.com. By no means is any part of this lecture to be sold or edited without prior permission of SalafiTapes.com. For more information, please contact us on info@SalafiTapes.com.